Alright. Wow. Just super out of nowhere. Alright. Evens up on life, pretty much. Switches it up. Takes off the claw. Now he's just showing what's up. Watch out. Gets him. Plants him. That's a really good floor. It heals itself. That's awesome. We should all get that. Variety Room takes number one. We go straight back into Elite. Alright. Hold on, we'll be. Yep, there we go.
Round one.
Right. Let's get those games taken care of. Queen, hold down. Crush. Don't show me I'm hideous. Close to stun. Watch out, here he comes. Headbutt. Good meaty, good pressure. Perfect. Whew. Good seven letters.
Round two.
What's up? EX. Flying Barcelona. Alright. Got clock getting gutsy here. Oh. God, that damage. That crush counter. Right, good throw. Don't want to be jumping in when he's charging that armor. Strong. Yeah. Oh, misses it. Oh no, that was intentional. I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh, the jump, Edgy, don't jump it. There you go, room two. Alright, that was that, folks.
Yeah. I keep wanting to jump so bad. What's it all?
This is right. Third win.
Room showing him what he can do, giving him some advice. What a good guy. Find out who's up next in a sec on stream. Right. Coming up next on stream, Just a Finn and a Morrison. Morrison decided he wants to be in Street Fighter V because he wants that bank. Because he knows he can get it. He was holding out because he didn't want to be a meanie face. Alright. We got a Chun-Li. Versus... I don't know, Justin plays a good handful of characters. Maybe Ryu. Maybe another Geef. Who else? I think he's... got a kid? Wait, Morrison, who did you log in as? Tyler Rash? Okay, that's player one. Alrighty. Alright, now we got a beak stick. Alex, you just want to leave it on this? Alright. Alright, yep. Woo versus KMA. Here we go. Right. Trade. Actually, who's a good knuckle? All right, good. Oh, that's right, yeah. He plays Cammy in this game. I don't know why I can't think it was Chun-Li. Alright, good pressure. Jump away. Sweet. Blocks, but Ryu pressure. Good. Can't jump in on him. Too many anti-airs. Ballsy answer. Uh-oh. Alright. That was a safe range. Hurricane. Didn't anti-air. Could have DP. Alright, that was good. Oh. EX. Good block. I thought that was going to cross up. Alright. Alright, that's good. Ooh, crush. It's just a guy. Alright. Mom, my lonesome, doing a terrible job. Alright. Handing over our other headset too.
You're not doing a terrible job. I just feel like joining you. Got knocked down by Cammy and wake up to a throw. Ryu says, Tominagi, get off me, girl. Ooh. He acts spiking me here.
What's up? Cool again.
Spin knuckle. Not doing well.
Right.
Not punished, so, I mean, it's not bad.
Ooh.
Spike.
Got V-trigger. She can use get this win here.
Oh, mid-kick.
That Daigo tech.
Ooh, dead, son.
Just defend one.
Making Goku happy with that Kamehameha wave.
Taking a page from Daigo's book.
Ryu looks at his fist and he says, it's not. Oh man, Arcane chasing around on Ryu. I mean, what do we do about this? Right, going to round two, Osaka opting to stick with Cammy with his guns. Spin Knuckles right through that Hadouken.
No anti air.
Hard sweep in response to a hard sweep. Nice little
pressure,
combo.
Pressure.
Jump over the Hadouken, no real spin through.
Hoogan, pull up. Hoogan throw, get it in. Hoogan knuckle, get it in.
Not punished.
Just the punish on that.
That's definitely interesting.
Ooh,
cannon assault from the air. Throw!
Go for punish.
Ooh, sweep.
Back to the middle of the mat. Oh, not safe.
And getting punished out of that.
Spyro.
Ooh, it's gonna cross through, so he can't really get a good punish.
Alright.
Oh, we invade trigger.
He's ready.
And any.
Oh, nope. Doesn't do anything.
Goes for a throw.
Lost. It's gone down. Okay, we can still do this.
We're both at health where a good hit confirm can lead to this, and Ryu gets the sweep and triggers. Set up a dungeon. Ooh! And Hoogan,
yeah,
hold it. Woo!
Oh.
Crouching medium kick. Toe right
so
to the knee. Says, get down, girl. You're out of my range. Stink Meaner in the background, not very happy with the punk players on the street. Spindicles through a Hadouken.
Go away. No anti-air. Oh.
No, you gotta play against Alex.
Probably looking for a normal.
Oh, cross up.
Here comes stun. And is he gonna get? No, not enough meter. Knuckles through. Jump in light. Oh, okay. No follow up on that. Could assure you. There you go. Deuce defend. Takes two over Osaka. Alright. Hold on, folks. Let's see what our next match will be.
Look, me.
Dang, dang.
Player one has a 5-win streak.
Playing. Sega Super Tech player one.
Did you answer five? Did you answer five?
Yeah.
Are you still on Cammy?
Yeah, I'm still on Cammy, yeah. I haven't gotten to play a whole lot lately.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I know that they're changing a bunch of stuff for season two.
Yeah, so December 20th, so.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Right around the corner.
I'm hoping they put Sakura in.
Well, they said it's going to be all new characters.
All new, okay.
Yeah. They already have, like, I think it's five characters coming, and they have the Skullrats for them, and they said they've never been in Street Fighter before.
So it's all new characters and Akuma.
And, yeah.
Yeah.
Burning Crusader! Oh, fuck, no!
Oh, I wouldn't have done it last time, though.
Alright, so we have...
Jury player. I have not seen a lot of Jury at all.
I've seen very little.
She definitely doesn't seem like a strong contender.
Okay, so D&D's I main Hanzo.
Round one. Fight.
I know Mika's got a lot of changes coming up also.
Yeah, alright, so already Mika's in the corner. Throws her out. Still big life lead. Another throw. And that's,
that's
first round.
Wow.
20 seconds.
Wow, that was fast.
That's how a lot of Mika matches go.
Right,
see if Jury can get something going this time. Alright, a little bit of more poking. Still not a lot of big damage, but doing a lot better.
Both characters sit in the full meter. Oh, there it is.
That's gonna do a lot of damage, but it's still not a kill. Let's see what the mix-up is. And that's the first match.
Mika wins.
Alright, so I'm gonna stay with the same character.
Fight!
I don't know a lot about Jury, but I feel like she should do a little bit more zoning in this matchup. Throw out some more fireballs.
Yeah, just try and keep her back a little bit.
Yeah.
Let Mika get in like that's not a good idea.
Generally speaking, no matter what character I have, I don't want to be anywhere near Mika.
Yeah. What's gonna happen here?
Whoa.
Oh, cross up. That's the first round.
That was a little wonky.
Yeah.
Ended up in Mika's favor.
And he's there.
That's a punish. Got a nice combo here. That's gonna do a lot of damage. Combo I have never seen before.
Yeah, I haven't seen that either.
And this is gonna be scary. Alright, Jury's back in this.
Now we're 1-1, yeah.
Jury wins.
I'm saying, like, because I need someone to
we're not really seeing a lot of neutral in this matchup. It's just whoever gets the knockdown seems to win.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, where's the wall?
That's so hard to deal with.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, that's round one.
Oh, no! Oh! Bobby!
I've never seen that before.
Wow, I haven't seen that. Her hair clips right through it. Alright, the hat's gone.
Huh. All right. Is that not punishable?
I don't know. Oh, that's not gonna be enough. Yeah.
That looked pretty safe though.
Oh. Alright, round two.
Oh, that should have been a punish. Wonder what he was going for, that jump. Oh, nice counter. Those are out the corner though. This is the OP. Pick her up again.
That's gonna hurt.
And back in the corner.
Oh, here's a chance to do some big damage.
Possible execution error there.
And that is game. I mean, Hanzo takes it.
Yep. I want to go say hi to Donnie.
Okay,
good
work.
I think it's okay.
Oh.
I guess you're on player one side.
Next up, we're gonna have Mika versus Zangief. What are your thoughts on Mika versus Zangief?
Hopefully, B&B knows the matchup now.
Oh, well, first off, we got pre-match Vroom shit talking.
Vroom is a boss.
He gets right in his opponent's head, makes them think that they just don't know this matchup.
So we got Vroom and whatever D&D wants to go by this week.
I main Hanzo.
I guess D&D's nickname this week is a pot shot at Trump.
Yep.
Does D&D also complain about team composition?
Yes.
Yes! Yes, we're in bed! We're in bed!
right? Another 360. And another 360.
Watch these two play about a first of 30 last night. Vroom has, contradictory as it is for a Zangief player, Vroom has more success when he doesn't go for the SPDs and just strikes D&D to death. Like that.
Ah. Oh.
Exact. That's case in point right there. D&D is respecting all of the spinning pile driver attempts.
Oh, got the stun.
I would have hyped off so much if he pulled out the mic, dropped it, kicked into combo. Ooh. Max range pile driver.
Another SVD.
Ooh. Ooh. Good call out on the jump there.
And
ooh,
that is
just
a whiff.
Barely out of range.
Right into 360. And another 360. First one goes to Broom.
This is the seventh win for player one.
Round one. Fight!
Oh, that was a missed pile driver. D&D throwing him into the corner. Never where you want to be against Armika.
Right.
Oh, and here goes the blender.
There we go. Oh, right behind him. Back in the corner.
Oh.
There. Oh. Oh no.
Oh.
Oh, he missed. Okay.
Oh. Nice setup. One of the few times D&D didn't jump. Oh, that sounds like, coming from him, it sounds like he missed the back dash there.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh. Vroom finally able to make a little headway with these jumping jabs.
Oh, oh god.
Here we go.
Here we go, combo.
And now Mika.
There we go.
Mika, things are happening.
Oh, stun. This is his chance.
Oh. Look at all that redness!
Oh! Zangief's getting a new hat for this match. D&D getting the early momentum this round. And there we go. I don't like that decision. Hmm. Yeah, D&D should have done EX shooting Peach there to take him to the corner. Hmm. No. Good conversion. Ooh! D&D respecting the hell out of that pile driver. And this sets tied up. Broom being the aggressor early in the set. I said before, I think his key to winning this set is to keep doing those standing fierces. Focus less on the power driver setups, because D&D is respecting the hell out of a grounded power driver. Now we're in the corner, and in the corner is where Mika things happen. Zangief disrespecting both women. Oh, now that was just silly.
double dash into EX bear grab. That was hilarious.
Round two.
Vroom getting first pile driver. Will he go for a strike? Yes. Oh. Whew, that was scary. D&D jumping out of almost every pile driver setup.
Final round. Fight.
Oh. And this is where we start Amika come back. Throw him in the corner. Both players respecting each other's abilities. What's going on, Toby? So we're getting some correspondence straight from glorious Nippon. And D&D advances. Again, we went through this last night. I think Vroom went for a few too many power driver setups. Need to do more just straight punching with Zangief. D&D played it right. He knows that Vroom loves to go for power driver, so he jumped out of all of them. Almost. Now we get to rock out to this amazing victory music.
Lover and Zegas. Lover and Zegas.
Right. Zegas is up next, I believe he's a... Oh, that's the damn truth. I don't know how I'm alive either, Tyler. By the grace of God and by the body's natural systems to cleanse itself from too much alcohol is the only reason I'm alive today. Feeling better. I think anything's better than almost dying of alcohol poisoning. Now Zegas, I believe, is a jury player. I'm not sure who Lover plays, because I was still unconscious and missed most of the first rounds.
No soul.
So we're gonna have a jury Vega matchup. Pretty much any jury matchup is a matchup we don't get to see often. And now I'm gonna be joined by this Hanzo main over here.
Hey, what's up going on, Iceman?
Keep complaining about them team compositions.
Alrighty.
Lover with a little bit of early momentum.
Alright. So Jury wants to get in. I feel that's where she's going to shine. She's got some stuff stocked, so she's got that damage output. And Vega, he's doing good here too. He's getting some good reads and some baits.
While he still has the call on, Vega doesn't want to get all the way in necessarily, but staying about the end of standing medium punch range.
Ooh, alright.
And Lover takes it for a frail. The hard call out with forward heavy into V-trigger.
Oh, oh.
Yep, right about that range right there.
Make him whiff, get some whiff punish. Yep. Alright, tries to enter, that's ballsy. Ooh, good crush. Capitalize. Nice.
And
whoa,
now,
nice.
Jury things are happening.
Ooh, damage. Ooh. I think she started that at the right point where it wasn't going to damage scale too much.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Can that hit? Off an EX Barcelona slap into, I guess, EX backhand.
Yes, yes, that is a combo.
All right.
He was just a little late with it.
I don't play claw, I just lose to him.
Now that he has no claw, Vega also wants to get in with some positive frame so he can go for his command grab shenanigans.
Yes, his is good. Those shenanigans are great. But Drury ran it back, so now we're 1-1 on the first game.
Oh no,
we're out of shock. Oh no, getting angry. Tio's getting angry. He's gonna have to settle for less now. Alright. Ooh, good air grab. Yeah, I think that might have been an attempt at.
This is about the pace of match that Vega wants to maintain. Ooh,
wow.
I'm not sure what either
That's
one of them
the first
was
time I've ever seen that actually happen, where his EX Barcelona gets anti-aired right away. Oh, I'm Ooh. Pretty sure he's trying for
good
that
dash
air grab.
Grab.
EX, if he gets one more in, it's his. Ooh! The dancing is a sweep. Alright, so
Zegas takes the first game.
There we go. Jump in. Pressure. Crush!
Gonna be really close to stun. Oh, just missed the throw.
Was almost. Wow. The float.
EX wall dive trade, but.
Zegas is doing everything right now. He's using her normals at a great range, keeping them out poked.
The claw is off, so it's time for Vega to go in. He's gonna win this round.
Lost that face mask.
Oh.
What's it? Good blocks. I would have attempted to grab right there, and I probably would have ate whatever he was chucking.
Hmm. Good V reversal. Just keep him in the corner.
Attempted.
Ooh.
And poker for those, fishing for the overhead. All right, Zegas on match point. I think Lover here, Vega, he needs to start getting a lot more aggressive.
All right. Yeah. He's managed to push her into the corner.
Pushing her way out. He's getting back at it.
Hmm. Oh. But keeps going for those jumping leg kicks.
Woo. Triple dash. Balls. Overhead. All right. He's doing good now. She's up. All right. Stun. It's no longer really an issue here. Ooh.
Hmm. Is that the round?
I don't think so.
Not quite.
The
yellow V-trigger.
Just fishing. I think we're going to be seeing a lot. Oh. That was that, folks. Zegas takes it 2-0 over Leva.
Zegas, stay there. More 2-8-5. I don't.
It's not changing. Oh well. Oh, good job. Alrighty.
And Zegas is staying up to go against Just a Finn.
we gonna see is Ryu, baby. Alright, you're getting set up. Choosing stage.
Oh, we got our
Wasteful
Jinvi tan up on the screen.
Hey, that's correct. I am oddly sober. That'll be fixed some point.
I mean, at this point, if I wasn't sober, I'd probably be dead, so.
Ready for that. Still going, I guess.
Alright. We're doing this on the esports stage.
The Capcom Cup. I got those Knuckle Doo statues in the back. Made them really buff.
Right. I would kind of laugh if that's the next update to the game. Change the statues to Knuckle Doo.
Actually, it'd be kind of neat. But, I think Ryu.
Justin, controlling the pace of the round. Going at about the speed a Ryu player would want to go at. Avoiding the V skill.
I think Ryu's got a leg up on Jury in this matchup.
Ooh.
For damage. Probably
that's
very similar damage output, but I think Ryu just has much more answers for certain things. Like, he just pretty much, if you're fighting against Ryu that know what they're doing, you never jump on him, pretty much.
Man. Yeah, very few characters can reliably jump on Ryu.
Oh wow, he's already got a full beater. Right. Might see some explosiveness in this round.
Oh, if Justin lands a clean hit, he's gonna unload that stick of butter.
Alright. A little bit of chip. Pressure going. Up, chucker in the corner. Ooh, alright, that was nice.
Great V skill, get it out of the corner.
Alright.
Oh, but put herself in the corner. I don't like that decision.
Loose position to maintain pressure, and against this kind of character, I don't think that's good. Oh, alright. Just Defend is fishing for that standing medium kick. But Zegas is here with some explosive damage. Ooh, it's good. Ooh, tried to parry.
A good parry attempt,
but
just a little early.
Ooh, drops, but.
And Zegas.
Grab.
Alright. Loads his stick of butter and takes the run.
Made a lot of good choices. Alright, there we go.
Having some sound issues here.
Yeah, our playback seems to be having a
sound wave is packing our systems.
Oh no, it's Sambra. Alright, good damage. Oh yeah, our sound is FUBAR at the moment, but we can still see stuff.
That was Justin's opportunity right there. He got a little bit, but he could have done a hell of a lot more.
Alright. Oh, good. No,
oh, I missed this combo. That would have been the round. And Zegas takes game one.
Zegas for game one. Just a little too far out. How do I refresh? I don't know how to refresh this thing. There it is.
Justin peppering him with relentless fireballs.
He's not doing it. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not going to bother with it.
But he threw one too many.
But Zegas one, Just Defend zero. Just Defend is doing a good job here. Pressure. Ooh, nice.
That was pretty. Calling that heavy kick out with a parry.
That was sweet. The shimmy.
Just the tiniest of shimmies.
That was a good one. Right. Up. No anti-air there. None of them there either. Right. Footsies. Alright, fireball more. We will win this. if it's not direct hits, he's getting a decent amount of chip.
First jumping light kick of the day from Ryu.
Mission for a crush, I think. There you go. Number two. Oop, nice. Alright. Justin's pushing a lot of buttons and they're winning out here, but that was a good jump in. He's in a good damage. Even with an okay amount.
Yeah.
Oh.
Justin is one clean hit away from taking this.
Alright. Get her off for a little bit. Okay.
Choosing to use that meter for EX fireballs.
He's gotta watch out. He's gotta watch out for lows, gotta watch out for overhead.
Good backdash there. And a great answer with the jumping jab.
That jumping jab is working out really well for Zegas. He's been using that a lot, it's been doing him a lot of good.
Honestly, for a lot of characters, that is your best anti-air option in this game. Just meet him in the air with a jab.
That was good anti-air. Oh! Getting tricky here. Crush!
Oh!
Alright, missed.
We have some hype in Blaze Blue Casuals. Ooh, nope, that was the wrong crush counter button.
Alright, good button, good button.
Zegas.
Ooh, there's a shimmy again.
Zegas is still in this safe.
Oh, that's... Oh, that was a bad trigger.
Alright. So you played Jury. Are there any invulnerable frames on that V-trigger startup, or was that just a plain mistake?
That was just a plain mistake.
Okay. Justin ties the set up.
There aren't really any invul, it's combo extender or it's hit the pause button so you can check and see what's going on.
Yeah, he hit the pause button, but what was going on was fireball in his face.
Fireball was right in him.
Ooh. Alright. Just out of range to get all that good Ryu damage.
But good job seeing that his standing light didn't connect, so he wasn't going to commit to a Tatsumaki.
Now, learning from his first round where he committed to that Dragon Punch, he got heavily punished.
Going for these safer options here, and it's really working out. This is a huge life lead. Zegas can still do it, but I don't think he needs to be spinning any meter right now. Ooh, good anti-air.
Good wake-up uppercut.
Bad timing on that neutral jump. Good blocks, good blocks. What do we got? Alright. Push off. Overhead. That dash up overhead. Good stuff.
Gowra cut her on top of the dome.
Bonk, bonk. Just a fan on match point. Ooh, good jump in. Gets a hit at least. Alright, good combo. Dash up. Grab. That's fast. Oh, crush. Overhead.
Zegas not wasting any time this round trying to get it back.
Alright.
Now does he?
How much
he gonna blow it?
Smart. No, saves it.
Saving the meter for next round.
Oh no. Darn. Overcommitted to that fireball. There's nothing he could do.
Yes, he did.
Right. This match, he straight up footsies and meter management. Ooh, what challenge. He's pretty safe after that.
Oh no. Justin's escaping the corner.
Fishing.
Oh, he's fishing for a way to burn.
Oh, cross
chose the EX fireball there.
Got, alright. What a challenge. Zegas takes it. Zegas is 2 to Justafin's 1. Hold on and we shall see. See who is next.
You're not real!
You're logging out.
Alex versus D&D.
Woo! I'm up next. Alright.
D&D can get in there and clap like a horse.
Like a
retard. Oh my god!
Getting ready for that Mika. We're getting ready for that Mika.
my god! Even go to the tackle box! Oh man. Alright, this is the last one. Oh man. That was beautiful.
Checked. Now let's go into this match. Should be Urien versus Mika, unless Alex has some more tricks that I haven't seen. And Maya joining me, so I don't have to do this commentary solo.
Yeah. Are you getting sound through your headphones? I'm just getting game audio.
That's all I'm getting too.
Okay.
That's why I'm cheating and keeping this one ear out of the headphones so I can hear you talk.
That's a good idea. Alright, I don't think I've ever seen Alex play D&D in this game.
I haven't either.
It should be interesting. I feel like Urien can handle Mika though.
Well, Urien's taking the early lead in stripping. Ooh. Decent punish for that missed clap.
Alright, Mika got him in a corner.
I respect that EX headbutt.
Yeah, that's a good call. Back in the corner.
But D&D no early, you ain't afraid.
Oh. Ooh, punish. No ages though. There we go.
There we go. And Mika thinks will happen.
More wake up headbutt. That's unsafe, but no punish. Alright.
That's
solid combo. There's the punish.
Oh, and D&D misses there.
Yeah, that EX headbutt is going to be crucial in this match.
I don't really like D&D's combo choices though when he does the crap.
Yeah.
He doesn't go for the. Not one time have I seen him do the usual bread and butter back dash, charge drop kick, EX shooting peach to take him to the corner.
Right.
He just goes right into the EX air grab.
Let's see if we get it this time. Oh yeah, meter.
No, didn't have any meter there to do anything, EX.
Alright, we got buttons. And
okay.
Stun. There it is. Ooh, Dark Urien.
I'm impressed. Being anywhere near a corner with Mika, somewhere you usually don't want to be.
Yeah. But
Alex not showing any of fear.
Nice punish.
So, we've had some controller problems. Somebody didn't desync. But the result's still the same.
Yeah.
So we've gone from hype Blaze Blue Casuals to a Garou call out.
So what?
I just heard CB and Garou.
Uh-oh. I'm ready for that. Did you pick it up on PS4?
I haven't picked it up yet on PS4.
I got it. Game is hard as shit. Did you ever get on that game?
I got out a little bit.
Who did you play?
Well, the world is just not ready for my butt. Kinda like what you should do in this game. Don't know what to play? Just play this shutter that does a million damage.
Yeah.
So if that anyone ever just said to you, man, I want to be able to play her, that would make Third Strike complete for me.
No.
Exactly.
But Third Strike has like a completely new cast. Like everybody, there's not that many classics in that game.
Which is why it surprises me that they're doing all new characters, because outside of the hardcore community, Street Fighter 3 was a commercial flop.
Oh yeah, I know that. Like I don't know if it's a good choice for commercial sales, but I mean Third Strike is my shit, so I like it. And the new characters could be dumb. I know that there's that possibility, but I still want to see some fresh stuff happen.
I mean, the only random character from story mode that I expected to see was like Balrog's adopted kid. If you didn't know, Balrog's like now the best father in the Street Fighter universe.
I didn't know that.
Play all the story mode. If you play his personal story mode, Balrog's doing the double cross.
So wait, we have a run back?
We have a run back.
Is this tournament? I guess it is, because that's what the names are.
And
so, for those that didn't see, D&D won the last match, but a lot of times this goes to Vroom.
Well, they played a lot last night.
Oh, did they?
And Vroom's gonna have to find a button that he can jump with that doesn't lose to Mika's down fierce. And I really think the key to this, as counterintuitive as it is, Vroom needs to stop going for pile drivers as much.
Yeah.
Because D&D's just jumping, back dashing, doing anything he can to not get hit by a pile driver. Okay. Yes. That's the combo D&D needs to use more. And that's not the command grab he should have chosen. That one wasn't.
Alright, D&D seems to have this figured out right now.
Oh, he's got this
round. That's perfect.
So D&D threw him back out of the corner and it didn't matter one bit.
Nice snatch.
Put him back in the corner where the Mika things happen.
Again, but not in the corner.
Oh no, that was a drop. While I do think that Vroom needs to focus more on buttons and meaty setups, the down fierce punch might not be the button he needs to choose.
Yeah. So, when she does the clap, can you control what side they go to?
Oh, on the Irish whip?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. I thought so. Nice anti air. Another punish.
That is.
D&D might have this figured out.
He definitely had the advantage in this match last night. Just do it. And he needs about two more of those to. Oh no, we hit a button.
I haven't really seen much of Geek's B trigger.
Finding the gap of pressure. That's what he needs to do right there. Something else that Vroom needs to spend if he has any time left. Well, the next time they meet, something else Vroom should think about. He doesn't need to always move forward.
Yeah.
It's okay if he just takes a second, waits, and then begins to advance.
Yeah. Vroom's metagame is really solid. He has a way of telling when his opponent is getting frustrated, but there's some things in neutral that he can work on.
It definitely shows his experience in Street Fighter.
Yeah.
And his Smash background, where Smash is a game where you almost never want to be standing still. Damn. That was a good setup from D&D and an even better block. I'm a little let down. That's the best setup D&D's had all day with me. He couldn't Vroom block like he's seen it already.
Yeah, Vroom's definitely being a little impatient. Mika's not really a character you need to rush down. Well, he has something going here. Nice stun.
And just poke her out with the chops. Final round. Fight. 2-0 for D&D.
Hey,
roll him into the corner. Oh, that's a good answer. I respect the 720 attempt, even if it didn't pay off.
So close this time.
Oh, give her the atomic drop.
Nice.
And that's the bet.
Hey.
Well, I gotta win 2 sets now. Shit. How many you got? What?
It's all right. It's
I should be 10 or 11.
I'm not sure why, but we're hearing an ad for something. It must be Twitch ads. So we're getting a run back from this Jurgen Mikkelsen. Yeah, that is definitely an ad. That's not Balrog's hype music. So we're gonna have this grand finals in Las Vegas. Hype men, dancing girls, all of it. Pimps. Shadow boxing pimps at that. Pretty good punish with no meter.
Alright, we got Aegis. Don't need it.
Don't need it. So. Good anti-air. And takes him to the corner. Going for that max damage.
Too hungry. You want it at stun.
Good cross up. Here we go. Oh, we did the wrong Aegis.
Alright, this is Street Fighter 5, so anything can happen. Ooh, nice.
Dandy showing him no respect with the wake up.
None at all.
Which, I don't blame him, I wouldn't respect it either. I've seen very few airtight meaty setups today.
Something got stuck there, it looks like an EX tackle.
There we go, throws him into the corner. Doing everything he can do to keep him in that corner.
Lots of wake up EX moves.
Got him with the same setup, back to back rounds.
It's disgusting. That's Marvel 3 stuff.
Yeah, as soon as Mika gets V-Trigger, it turns into some Marvel 3 or Zotto or whatever you want to call it type of crap.
Punish. Crush counter, nothing out there. That's the only reason. That's the only reason. We've been doing this since, like, the Ace 3 Fighter came out.
I love that D&D is no longer throwing his opponents out of the corner, he's keeping them there.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Hey. Go ahead. I can get a copy from work for $12, so.
Yeah, he needs to start baiting those.
Very, very poor punish to that miss shooting Peach.
Just letting it rip with EX tackles.
Ooh,
nice. Good EX headbutt to avoid everything.
Yeah, very nice answer. EX headbutt is so good.
Yes, it is.
If it whiffs, it's like impossible to punish.
Get clapped, son. Again, that EX headbutt. We'll just take turns jumping each other's throw setups.
Neutral mix or neutral jump.
Ooh,
the game.
Almost stunned Mika, and now the magic happens.
Urien doesn't care.
Uh-oh.
Now he has Aegis.
D&D jumps and forgets to hit a button.
I think he was afraid of that Aegis.
I think he was too.
What's the count right now?
Is it 1-1 or 2-1?
I think it might be 1-1.
Round 1. Fight.
I was just about to brag that the best thing I've seen from D&D is not throwing his opponents out of the corner. It's right on the tip of my tongue, and before I could say it, there he goes, throwing him back out of the corner. And the other thing, too, is if he chooses the kick command grab and keeps him in the corner, he gets a throw loop.
Yeah.
Just douse up, and you're in the same mix-up. Is he going to do it again? And knowing D&D, he's going to do it again.
We're not sure.
It's either 1-1 or 2-1 D&D. We're not sure on that part. Here we go. The Mika driver. Here we go.
Nice.
Needed that B reversal. Got it. D&D is having confirms all weekend.
But we don't care because we have Aegis.
Yep.
Oh, what up, that?
Yeah, from both of these characters, we have the best setup V-triggers in the game.
Yeah, that's true.
Good punish from D&D. And puts Urien in the corner where she wants him.
There hasn't been one block EX headbutt.
That's a good point. His percentage on the EX headbutt is probably still 100.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. I love it.
That was nice.
Dirty. Just let it rip. Alright, what's he got up his sleeve now?
He has.
Oh, a good throw break.
Okay.
I think he's only 1-2 as well.
Nobody knows what the count is right now.
I'm pretty sure I only 1-2.
Yeah.
Corey, if you're watching, tell us what the count is.
Yeah. Yeah, it was either. We just
set that bracket.
No.
Okay, it's 2-1 then.
Yeah, it's 1-2.
So here we are, 5 grown ass men, and none of us can count the 3.
Ooh.
pretty poor punish on that shooting peach.
Hey, D&D's got his chance now.
Scoop!
Still not in the corner.
Scooped him out of the corner.
Yeah.
Hmm, there we go. D&D finished it off with the Bulldog for stylish reasons.
I'm gonna have to yell at Alex later for dying without using Aegis. Nice speed reversal.
Alright.
Hmm.
Alright, this is Smash Point. If D&D wins, we get a reset.
And on cue, right as Smash Point. Right as the final round begins, we get another ad for something.
Yeah.
Shout out to Twitch ads. So for our viewers, please buy whatever this ad is selling so maybe they'll leave us alone. PlayStation, apparently.
This is looking like the game, yep.
And that's the tournament. And Alex is a winner today. He did a good job of avoiding the Mika setups.
All of those V reversals were pretty smart, but I'm still a little salty I didn't see more Aegis.
Closing comments? More Aegis.
And more Blaze Blue.
And more Blaze Blue.